Hello there. In this video, we are going to create a form and go through the basic form settings and features. Go to WP Booking System, Forms, and click on the Add New Form button. Give your form a name and click on the Add Form button. You will be taken to the form editing page. The first tab is the Form Builder tab. In the sidebar on the right, you will see all the available form fields split into three categories. Basic form elements, like text inputs, drop-downs, checkboxes, and radio buttons. Advanced form elements, like HTML fields, date pickers, consent checkboxes or signature fields, and finally, pricing form elements like product fields that can be used to add extra charges to the form. Coupons, security deposit, and fields for displaying the pricing table and the available payment methods. Let's start building a sample form to help us better explain how it works. We are going to recreate the advanced demo form from our website. You will find a link to it in the video description. First, let's add fields to get the customer's name. We're going to use text fields and call them first name and last name and make them both required. In the advanced options, you can set a placeholder for the text input, set a default value, display a description below, change the size and position of the field, add a custom CSS class, hide the label, and enable dynamic population. Some of these options can be translated in different languages as well. We can also enable conditional logic for fields, allowing us to show or hide the field based on another field's value. We'll get back to this a bit later. Let's change the layout options for the name fields to place them side by side. Then let's add the email field, make it required, and add a small description. Let's add the phone number field as well. Let's also add a HTML field and move it to the beginning of the form. We're going to add a heading that says personal information to help better organize the form. Now let's duplicate it and change the heading to booking information. The next field we are going to add is a text area field and name it additional requests, where the customer can write any text they want. We're also going to add a placeholder text to this field. In the demo, the price we have set in the calendar is for 3 people, but we can add extra beds that can accommodate 2 extra people for the price of $20 per person per night. For this, we are going to use a product drop-down field. We'll call it number of people and add the options from 1 to 5. Since the price for the first 3 people is already included, we are going to set this to 0, then we are going to add an extra $20 for each additional person. Set the price calculation per day and add in a small description for the field. Next, we're going to add some extras like swimming pool access or gym access. We are going to add these using the product checkbox field. Name the field extras, add in the 2 options, and add a price for each. Let's add a field for parking as well. We're going to add this as a product radio field with the options yes and no. For yes, we set a price of $75 per stay. If the customer decides to buy the parking as well, we'll want to take their vehicle registration plate number. We can create this as a text field and use conditional logic to display the field only if needed. Click on the conditional logic link and tick the enable switch. Select the parking field, leave the comparison rule to is, and type in yes in the comparison value. Let's add a total field as well to display all the price calculations and a payment method field to allow the customer to select their desired payment method. Finally, let's add a consent checkbox. We will name it terms and conditions, type in something like I agree with the terms and conditions in the checkbox label. And in the checkbox link, add in the link to your terms and conditions page. That's pretty much it. Our form is ready. Click on the Save Form button to save the changes. Now let's go through the other options. Click on the Form Options tab. Please note that not all tabs and subtabs may be available, depending on which add-ons you have installed. First, notice the Dynamic Tags box. This appears in almost all option tabs. You can use these tags in most settings fields. They will be replaced with user data entered in the form or booking details. In the General Options tab, you can change things like the label of the form's Submit button. You can add a tracking script in the form of a small JavaScript code that gets executed after the form is submitted. Automatically fill in the description or tooltip fields in the calendar whenever a booking is made. For example, you can add the customer's first name. And finally, you can give other WP admin users access to edit the form. In the Form Confirmation tab, you can select what happens after a form is submitted. You can either show a confirmation message or redirect the customer to a thank you page. Next is the Payment Options tab. Most payment options are configured from the Settings page, but some options can be set or overwritten per form. You can overwrite the default product name that appears in the pricing table, multiply the calendar price by a form field, hide a line in the pricing table if the value of that line is zero, and add custom bank transfer instructions if the bank transfer payment method is used. The Contract Settings tab is only available if the contract's add-on is installed. Here you can write the contract body text and select which emails to attach the contract to. Same goes with the Invoice tab. It only appears if the Invoices add-on is installed. Here you can populate invoice sections like the buyer details, seller details, and add some footer notes, and select which emails you want to attach the invoice to. In the Email Notifications tab, you can set up automated emails to be sent to you, the website administrator, or to the customer. The admin notification and user notification emails are sent whenever a new booking is created. Click on the toggle box to enable the notification. The send to email address is selected from the form fields. You can add multiple recipients by adding additional emails in the CC or BCC fields. Fill in the from name and email address and optionally add a reply to email address. To improve deliverability, the from email should be an email from your website's domain. Add a subject and a message as well and optionally attach an iCalendar event file to the email so the customer can easily save their booking in their calendar. You can also set up a final payment reminder email and a final payment confirmation email. These are available when the part payments option is enabled, a reminder email and a follow-up email. The options for these are the same as for the user notification email. If you have the SMS notifications add-on installed, you can also set up SMS notifications for the same events as for email notifications. Next is the Form Strings tab, which overwrites the default string set in the Settings page. And finally, the Booking Restrictions tab that is available if you install the Advanced Booking Restrictions add-on. You can set restrictions such as the minimum or the maximum stay length, enforce a fixed number of days, set a minimum stay length based on the starting day of the week. Only allow a booking to start or end on a certain weekday. Set an advance reservation period like how many days from today the customer can make a booking or how far in the future they can book. If you set a minimum advance period of 7 days, the customer can only make a booking starting from next week. The last option is a turnaround time option. How many free days must there be between bookings? These are global restriction rules and are applied all the time. You can add new rules that apply for certain periods only. They can be recurring, for example setting high season restriction rules each year between June and September, or fixed date rules that are only applied in a single year. The other options are the same, except for the priority field at the bottom which allows overlapping restriction rules for the same periods. You can also set fixed date intervals. These are periods that can only be booked starting and ending on the dates you set. You can also set a custom price for this period. This is useful for renting your home on holidays like Christmas or New Year's Eve. Click on the Save Form button again to save the settings and that's it, your form is ready. More details and information about the forms can be found on our website in the documentation section. Thanks for watching.